For those who don't know me, my name is Miranda Chen, and I'm your valedictorian for the class of 2018. So when I was beginning to write this speech, I was told I had a few jobs for today. I was to give credit where credit was due, recount a few good times we've shared over the years, and finally, highlight some of our defining attributes as a grade.
I think honest is probably the one that comes up the most.
I'm going to say passionate.
Powerful.
Tenacious.
Unpredictable.
Fun-loving. Passionate. Wow. Passionate? For sure. Passionate.
I was going to say personable.
They're synonyms.
I think you're a very personable grade. Made up of very nice people.
There's no way I can describe you using one expression. All I can say is I'm going to remember you in a warm way.
We get it almost every night.
Okay, here we go. And one, two, three. Duncan.
We've been together for 13 years, so I'm very connected.
Yeah. I've been at York House since kindergarten, so 13 years.
Kindergarten, so this is my 13th year.
This is my 13th year.
I've been at York House for 13 years.
I've been at York House since kindergarten.
For 13 years.
I actually get interviewed all the time, so.
Yeah, you're a professional.
I'm actually really good at this.
We've been together for so long that I just think it's crazy that we haven't gotten sick of each other yet.
And I figured out that you were my 26th kindergarten class. Your class, like many others, was rather nervous and shy in the beginning in kindergarten. And it's great for me as a teacher to see how you grow in confidence and in your skills.
Well, when you were in kindergarten, we were under construction. And we had most of our PE classes in Founders Hall on a carpeted floor or on the pavement outside the junior school. And girls would fall and they'd come to me crying with skinned knees, a little bit of blood, and just tears, tears, tears. And by the end of that year, girls were so just used to it that I can remember but someone just walking over to me with blood dripping down both knees. Oh, I fell. No tears, just matter of fact. We cleaned the girl up, put band-aids on, and she went right back to playing. So I just saw so much maturity just in kindergarten.
So I've been at York House for 5 years.
I've been at York House since grade eight.
Since grade eight. Since grade eight.
Grade eight.
I've been at York House since grade 8.
I remember coming into grade 8 and not really wanting to be here at all because like everyone had already known each other and I moved like schools from North Delta, so it was a big change in my life, like coming to an all-girls private school.
I remember being like a little intimidated by everybody because everybody was already so close, but like everybody was so nice that everything just like flowed really smoothly and everybody got to know each other really quickly.
Even now, I kind of forget who's a lifer and who's not because we all get along so well.
I can't use one word. I have multiple words. So I think of supportive, caring, empathetic.
I would say tenacious.
Fighting spirit.
What is one word that would best describe our grade? One word or phrase.
That's what I know. Rambunctious. What does rambunctious mean?
Coming in, I think we were warned by the junior school that you were a rambunctious bunch. And that was the case.
I heard there was maybe some rowdy types.
They came in with a bit of a reputation. They were a bit of a handful, is what I was told. Mm-hmm. But then they came in. And I would say they were lots of fun, mm-hmm. and lots of energy. I saw lots and lots of energy.
In grade eight, I had probably one of the, well, when you guys were in grade eight, I had maybe one of the craziest classes I've ever had.
I remember thinking to myself, like, I do not know how to handle Cameron Wong on this end, who actually needed to like be doing sprints or something, and then Rosa Rahini, who needed probably to be like reading, I don't know, some philosophy books. So that was perhaps one of the funniest and most diverse grades that I've taught.
The most memorable moment or moments were probably the out trips, so like Garibaldi, Manning Park, Pitt Lake.
Garibaldi. That was really fun and it was cold, but everyone in our grade kind of stepped up and did something together, which was nice.
I think my most memorable moment that I don't think I'll ever forget is in the middle of Math 10 when Jacqueline just started crying, sobbing so loudly because she had too much green tea.
There's so many memories that I will remember forever, but I feel like pre-grad definitely last year was so much fun.
It was just after pre-grad. All I remember is, I don't even know how it happened, but all of a sudden Beau was in the middle of the room doing some dance that she apparently did at pre-grad, and it was definitely memorable, to say the least.
So I have a memorable moment from this group of girls in grade 8. And at that time, twerking was really, really popular. And so I remember being in class and having some couple of grade 8s jump up out of their seats and start twerking in front of us and in front of me. And I remember being highly disturbed by this. And it's been seared into my memory ever since. So I think when I retire, many years from now, that I will remember these particular girls twerking when they were like 12 years old in my class.
It feels amazing to be in grade 12. I remember in like grade 1 and 2 looking up at the grade 12s and thinking, oh my gosh, I can never imagine myself being that age and that stage of life, and so it's pretty surreal being here.
It feels really good to be in grade 12, and I hope that I've changed a lot since grade 8.
I think we're ready to graduate, and we're all really excited to graduate, but it's just a little weird.
I don't think we've changed that much.
I don't think we've changed that much.
We're taller.
Yeah. A lot taller. Especially me.
Definitely haven't grown physically. Like, I'm definitely more motivated.
Yeah.
There's so much more freedom, like, going to school late, leaving school.
Teachers talk to you with much more like, I don't know if respect is the right word, but just like
adult to adult.
Yeah.
I'm definitely really happy and excited to be in grade 12 because I feel like everything has just been put together when I'm in grade 12 as compared to in grade 8. Give me one reason to stay here
and I'll turn right back around. I'd say that right now my stress levels are like mediocre to relatively high.
10, 11.
Yeah. Mine are pretty low right now. I just finished my application, so I'm at about a 9.5.
Well, I want to go to university, obviously, hopefully into business.
I hope next year I can go to a university somewhere in Canada. Kind of a ways to go with other applications, but managing it okay.
What are your thoughts on Rosa's costume?
Oh, yeah. God, it's amazing. So creative.
So beautiful.
So beautiful.
Yeah, she looks beautiful.
She looks beautiful. Yeah. Really, really understands.
Smart, too, I think.
Character. Wow.
Really smart. Intellectual.
Cozy.
Cozy.
CCC.
Calm, confident, cozy.
What would you give it out of 10? Like?
Oh, 11.
Oh, okay.
That's a no-brainer.
The stress level for your grade compared to other grades has been much lower, actually, this year. That was not my sense when you were in grade 11, to be honest.
We're getting close to the end of 2017, so things are chilling a little bit.
Sorry.
Okay, every time I say, don't make me look stupid, I go and do more stupid stuff.
That was
so
funny. Thank you. Wonderful performance.
Maya Gerardi, it's snowing really hard in late February.
Guys, what just happened?
It's a snow day!
Yeah!
Yeah! Oh, yeah!
For the whole, I think students seem a whole lot more relaxed.
I've been hit by senioritis like a truck.
I don't think it exists as a disease. Mm-hmm. It's not a pathology. Yeah. It doesn't require treatment. It should just simply mm-hmm. not happen.
I kind of dread putting on my uniform every day.
Yeah. And I would be late to school, but now it's like so hard waking up in the morning.
I don't remember the last time I was on time for a class.
That's funny. Sylvia doesn't even call anymore. Like, I literally didn't go to class this morning and like nobody called. And my mom was like sleeping.
Are you starting to YOLO in term two, or are you still going strong?
A mix of both, I'd say.
I can't YOLO, so I'm holding on for dear life.
Are you being hit by senioritis?
Very
definitely
hard, yes.
I'm ready to get out of here, let's be real. But yeah.
As this year is coming to a close, I feel excited, but I'm also kind of sad just because I've spent 13 years at York House and I'm pretty sure no one's going to the same university as me next year.
I know that I will be really sentimental before I leave, but just at the moment, I'm still really excited about my new life in university.
It'd be really like weird for a little bit next year, just like not being with like all my friends and everything, and not like walking down the halls at York House, you like recognize, you like obviously know everyone, you can like say hi to everyone, and just not having that same sense of like familiarity.
It'll be nice to leave, but I'm also nervous, I guess, because like I've been at York House since kindergarten, so I've been coming to the same place every single day except for weekends and holidays for 13 years. So going somewhere different and being with new people, it's gonna be so weird.
There's 2 weeks left.
Oh my god.
We're in the midst of planning the graduation dinner dance.
It's really busy right now. Got really a lot busy. Of stuff going on.
Yeah.
Last minute details are all getting sorted out. Mm-hmm.
Grad is on June 14th. I'm really excited.
Me too.
How many weeks are there left in school?
I don't know.
We have nine school days.
Too many.
Nine
that's
school days?
Yeah.
And that's too many?
Come on.
Okay.
Three, two, one, go!
Anyway. We love Spirit Day. Woo! Got it!
Oh my god!
What will I miss most about York House? I think the environment and like all the people here. We're all really nice. It's like competitive, but it's like a good kind of competitive.
I feel pretty relieved knowing I've like made it through high school, and like just a little bit nostalgic.
It's kind of bittersweet, I think, because you're leaving your friends and the teachers who've helped you over the years, but then you're also getting a new start and new experiences. So I think, yeah, bittersweet's a good way to describe it.
I'll probably miss like walking through the hallways and knowing everyone and just having that like friendly environment. And the textiles room.
After 15 years of being away, I was certainly, you know, immediately reminded of the sisterhood and the way that the girls, you, all embrace each other and are so comfortable and supportive of each other. And I love that.
People have a lot of interests that they like to talk about and had lots of great conversations with people about primarily music and movies.
I feel like there are girls in this grade or students in this grade that are just really comfortable with themselves and really comfortable saying hi to the counselor because not a lot of people are.
You're all very friendly. When you see me, you greet me and you talk to me and I'm happy with that. Yep.
But it's just the day-to-day interaction I have with you. Coming in and signing in and smiling and seeing you in the hall. It's all memorable to me.
Sometimes there's grades that are just so obsessed with marks, but this grade has some kind of conscience and there's an angst to them and sometimes an over-angst to them, but I really like that though. There's an edge to them, yeah.
There's something warm about you guys on one hand. At the same time,
yeah, you are a bunch of characters, and you can be competitive, you can be passionate. There's this core that is beautifully transforming, revolving into this year grade 12 young women, and you are becoming beautiful swans. That's all I can say.
How do you feel about the fact that we all call you mom?
It drives me crazy. Miss Grant would just be nice. Miss G, G Money, T Rant, G Rant. Pretty much anything is better than mom.
Okay. You're just all my children that I really feel I need to nurture and herd you.
It's the last day!
Advice for your class going to university, as you go into university, I would say just everything's going to be all right. There's many different ways to get to where you're trying to go. It's more a matter of just responding to the opportunities that come along rather than having everything figured out from the beginning.
Relationships are so important in life, and ensuring that you keep in touch. You have a whole group of people here that are here to support you and work with you and want to remain in touch with you.
So when you go out to the world, remember it's like a garden, and it can be a butterfly, a bee, or a fly. Just make the right choices.
One of the constants in life is that there's going to be change. And one has to be able to, you know, realize that and work with it. And basically, I think one's just got to be resilient.
I think my advice going into university is try everything. One of my favorite sayings is, if you get rejection, it's actually not rejection, it's redirection.
Be open to other people, other ways of doing things.
I hope that you can go and have some fun and enjoy yourselves in university rather than be as stressed as you may be finding yourselves at this time.
Just enjoy what you have left in terms of your time with your friends, with the teachers that you are you have classes with currently.
I suppose it's a time of not necessarily being sure what's coming next and making plans for that and working hard to be able to get where you want to go. And in some ways, that's an expected thing.
Do what is right as you move forward in your lives, and good luck and have fun.
It's really been interesting to watch your grade. You came in full of beans, and I think you're leaving full of beans.
Definitely more mature, less stressed, still a little stressed, but definitely know how to manage it better, and still a little bit silly, which is what I like.
I'm gonna miss this grade a lot. I even got a tattoo, class of 2018, on my back. Can you imagine that? Right now, okay, let's start now. Let's do the real one.
Been traveling these wide roads for so long. My heart's been far from you 10,000 miles.
Whatever they said about us, they were right. We are troublemakers. We're proud of being troublemakers. And we are going to change the world. Thank you.
Take me to your river.